How long after a CO2 laser treatment should I wait before starting a series of non-ablative fractional laser treatments? I'm thinking of following up my CO2 laser acne scar treatment with a series of treatments with the Palomar Icon 1540nm XD laser. How long should I wait before starting my first treatment? I'm told the CO2 can only produce about a 50% improvement, which is why I plan on following it up with the Icon laser.
Thank you for your question. You're stating in your question that for your acne scars, after you undergo CO2 laser treatment, as you've become aware that the laser treatment may be up to 50% effective in terms of improving acne scars, that you want to know when to follow up the treatment with a 1540 nanometer laser, and how long after the CO2 laser you can do that. Well, I can certainly share with you, I think, some principles that are relevant to this type of question. A little bit of background: I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial, plastic, and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. I have been using lasers since the early to mid-90s, including the original CO2 ablative lasers. And it's certainly a time in the world of laser treatment where we have so many options. And I think it's when you have these many options, you have to also understand that there's clearly no one single best approach to any particular problem. And acne scars are one of the most challenging problems to treat. And what you have to think about is really looking at your situation through the lens of someone who is going to be able to manage you from all aspects and not just treat you with a laser. And the reason is to understand that acne, most people who have acne scars have a combination of scars. So whether they have rolling scars, boxcar scars, ice pick scars, atrophic scars, facial fat atrophy, there's a lot of different things that are usually the case when you evaluate someone. And so before you start with any laser, what I do is I look at the foundational basis of what gives a person smooth-looking skin. People always look at their skin and think that it's all about trying to smooth out the top layer. When you think about skin, you're looking at a structure that's about 2 millimeters in thickness in the face. You also have to think of volume below the skin. So when you ask a question like this, I would hope that you've also had a discussion with a physician about strategies. For example, when I evaluate a patient with acne scars, I take photos with direct light, and I take photos with backlighting. With backlighting, it shows me areas which particularly cast a significant shadow. And a lot of times I find that the most significant shadows are cast because of volume loss. So a lot of times what I'll do is, even on a younger person, I'll do something like structural volumizing by placing a long-lasting filler such as a Juvederm Ultra Plus or Juvederm Voluma at the cheek level, on the bone, and that results in a kind of restoration of volume. And when there's restoration of volume, acne scars look smoother. A lot of times with patients who come in who have experienced facial aging on top of acne scars, they really appreciate that significant change, probably more than anybody. But the point of this is understanding that you have to work from the inside outward. We also would combine other treatments as foundational ways to improve the skin's ability to respond. So I will sometimes combine this with platelet-rich plasma injection, microneedling with platelet-rich plasma. Basically, I try to minimize the amount of more aggressive ablative procedures before doing them so that we can get the skin healthy, get the skin full, and you may end up needing more conservative treatment. There's a basic principle in wound healing, And that is that after you have an injury, and that includes the controlled injury of laser resurfacing, then there is a proliferative phase of generating collagen that is essentially about a month or so. And I think based on that concept, you might be safe for you to go ahead and do a non-ablative procedure such as using this particular laser afterwards to try to stimulate collagen. But I would caution you that there's also a wound remodeling phase. And I would tend to lean on the more conservative before trying to stimulate the skin to generate more collagen, because you can only generate so much. And I think a lot of times people are frustrated because they get a laser, then another laser, another laser. A lot of times patients have come to me and their skin, after so many different laser treatments, actually looks fairly thin. And so then we do what we refer to as tissue rehab, where we're using platelet-rich plasma derived from your blood. We sometimes combine this with acellular matrix to help stimulate the fat cells and try to give the skin some substance before treating it with another laser. Interestingly, the world is coming full circle, and a lot of the luminaries who have been the biggest proponents for lasers are now advocating PRP as well as microneedling. So a little vindication is certainly something I'm enjoying. But nonetheless, I think that you really have to think through this process, because you should also have a realistic understanding of outcome. People, generally speaking, want to see significant improvement. And a lot of times, acne scar patients get very frustrated because they don't necessarily see the improvement, they only see where they're still loss. And so it's very important to have a very good relationship with your doctor and have clarity about what the outcomes will be and the timing. You know, we have a lot of tools, but you got to know when to use them and when to hold back and wait. And of course, ultimately, it's my goal to try to do whatever is most effective with the least amount of downtime and have a sense of really what will really make the most impact. You have to, unfortunately, accept that there's no perfect solution for acne scars. There's ways to treat and improve appearance, but certain things cannot be completely reversed. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.